Swansea City Under-12s have paid respect as well and learn a bit about the First World War. That's surely invaluable for children this age.
Definitely, yeah. I think to pay the respects to the people who have lost their lives and fought in the First World War and the ancestors, and one of our players fought in the First World War, one of our first team players at the time, and especially marking the Christmas Truce when, you know, the power of football even overcame the war and conflict that was going on during that time, that the German and British soldiers stopped to have a game of football, you know, between their two trenches and before the war was restarted, I think is just shows the power of football.
Yeah, we've learned a lot about the First World War. Like, we've done poetry and like we've gone on to loads of the like cemeteries and learned quite a lot about the sacrifices the soldiers made and everything.
Back, head up. No, fall back, head up. I said, look at them, don't look at me. Right.
We've been to the trenches and we were the only club who went to the Welsh one. And we got told like some stories about some of the players who played for Swans who were in the World War.
Well, I think the story about James Collins going on to play for Swansea was really, it inspired me. He risked his life for other people and he still went on to play football, as even though he stepped on a bomb and it really hurt his leg and he had a lot of injuries, so.
It was quite sad in a way, because like we don't even know them, and like you feel for them.
Has it inspired you to learn more about history and the First World War?
Yeah, a lot, because I don't normally like history, but ever since I've come here, I'm starting to like it a bit more.
Right, again, you know, we've sat down and spoke about it, and you know, the biggest thing is that, you know, even the soldiers in the trenches, they all stuck together, and that's exactly what the boys have to do on the pitch. You know, they're a team, and obviously the people who fought in the war, they fought as a team, so that's definitely something that they've taken from this.
What was it like to lay that wreath as well? Because you were chosen as the team captain to do the wreath laying at Menin Gate. What was that like?
Oh yeah, it was like really like happy to be chosen and just like to lay the wreath in front of loads of people on behalf of the club, and you know, it was really like good because, you know, it's like paying our respect to the soldiers who died in the First World War.
1, 2, 3, 4, 3!
Yeah, it was just absolutely fantastic, you know. The manager told me a few days before that I was going to get a game, and you know, I just couldn't wait. You know, I was so excited, but to get the 3 points was what was important, you know. It was just a fantastic feeling for all the boys and the staff, you know, to get the right result. Yeah, you know, it's always difficult when you're not playing, but as a professional footballer, especially as a young one, it's something that you've got to be able to deal with. You know, everyone goes through certain parts of the career is not playing, and you know, it's how you come out on the other end. And thankfully the staff have been really good, and you know, have worked with me, so I've managed to keep myself fit and, you know, patiently waiting for my chance. A little bit, you know, it's always nice just to win at the end of the day, but you know, being my old club, it was a little bit special, but at the end of the day it's just 3 points for the team, and you know, that's all that matters at the end of the day. Yeah, definitely, you know, especially Ash, you know, someone I look up to, and he's been in, he's played every game bar one or two maybe since I've been here, you know, so he's someone for me to look at and see what he does on and off the field, and you know, try and build my game around that. Just pretty simple, hard work, I think, you know, on the training field, the manager and Pep and the other coaching staff, you know, drilling into us what we need to do, where we need to be, and I think it comes second nature now. On the field you'll see players in the right position, and that's not out of luck, you know, that's from working, you know, day in, day out on it. Yeah, well, I think we quite like, you know, the pundits getting on our back a little bit, and we take a bit of motivation from that, you know. we all know what we're capable of, you know, as individuals and as a team, and we think with our work ethic, you know, we can go anywhere that we want to. Really. I'm not sure you could say there's ever a good time to go to Manchester City, you know, because we've got so many world-class players, but like you said, they've not been the best of forms recently, and I'm confident that the manager will set up a game plan and, you know, give us every possibility to go out there and get a good result. Yeah, I came up against Aguero a few years ago when I was back at Arsenal, and, you know, that was a tough task, and he's been, you know, exceptional this year. You know, out of all the Manchester City players, he's been the one shining light, really. So it'd be another tough task if I get the job, but, you know, I'm looking forward to it. Realistically, I think 3 points, you know, and a clean sheet if possible from a defender's side of, you know, I don't think we're going to go into any game, you know, home or away, against the champions or whoever it is, you know, thinking we're going to be defeated. You know, I think our confidence is that high at the moment. You know, I'm not saying looking further on in the season, I'm talking about just the next game. You know, we go into the next game wanting to win, thinking we can win, and, you know, we'll see what happens.
Yeah, we're going to a man called Tom. It is his 95th birthday on Monday, and he's our older season ticket holder, so we're going to go and present him with a signed card off the team and thank him for the support over the years.
How important do you think it is to reward like these fans who have been obviously dedicated fans over the years?
I think it's massive, you know, especially with these type of fans where he would have seen every up and down in the club's history. So, you know, to come and celebrate his birthday now, give him a card, and especially how we're doing in the league now is a perfect time.
And he doesn't know anything about it, it's going to be a complete surprise.
Yeah, it's a surprise. I think his daughter or granddaughter knows about it, but Tom doesn't know anything about it, so it'd be a nice surprise for him. Tom, how are you doing, mate? You okay?
How are you, brother?
Good, nice to see you. No problem at all, you're all right?
Yeah,
are you okay?
Yeah.
You're doing, mate, you're all right?
Yeah,
are you okay? Yes, and you as well. There's a card there as well.
Oh, Tom. Gracious. Took down a bit too.
He's a big lad, isn't he?
What do you think of that?
What's this, 1913?
Your photo's not in there, is it?
I don't think I was in this side, no. How long have you been a supporter?
Oh, Swansea. For a long time.
Yeah?
You should go down the old vetch,
the vetch, yeah.
Ah, of course, yeah.
Brilliant. So you would have seen everything, the good and the bad, every up and down, wouldn't you?
Yes. I even learned the songs.
Yeah.
Yeah,
lovely.
There you are.
You're
covering your
wrinkles,
Papa.
Don't smile, just check the light.
I mean,
I'll
fix
those, mate. Sorry, I'll
rush you. I've got better to come.
Right, can we have all the family in?
Oh.
Here we come, nice and close now.
After three.
One, two, three. Hey.
You spotted that straight away when we were on the tour, didn't
you? Yeah, he's got a birthday, mate. Nice to see you.
Thanks for giving you the time.
No problem at all. My pleasure, mate. My pleasure.
And I know all the songs now, don't I?
See where you are. Takes a while. You won't go home with us. You won't go home. No.